Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today we're going to be looking at VideoProc Converter AI. And basically this allows you to do many different things with your videos. For example, it can do super resolution. So if you shot a video at 720p, for example, and you wanted it at 1920 or even 4K resolution, this is the app to do it with. You can also do what's called frame interpolation. Now, frame interpolation is where it adds extra frames into your video to give that slow motion effect. And it's really used to give that slow motion effect or to increase your frames per second. You can also do stabilization. Now, stabilization, of course, we all know when we're doing a video and the video is all over the place, well, this can stabilize a shaky video. You can also do video conversion. So if you have one video and it won't play on a certain device such as your Mac or on an iPhone or other type of device that you may have, you can convert a video from one file format to another. If you wanted to convert a file, perhaps a movie that you have on your computer and convert it over to a DVD, if you have a DVD burner, yes, it can actually do that too, or take a file that you'd normally watch on a computer and convert to a DVD so you can watch it on your TV. It also has recording capabilities, so it can actually record from your webcam and create videos for you and even allow you to edit those videos. So let's take a look at the VideoProc Converter AI program. So here we are within the VideoProc Converter AI. And you can see all the tools here, such as the super resolution, frame interpolation, stabilization, video converter, DVD, the downloader, and also the recorder. What we're going to do is we're going to check out the super resolution here. So let's click on there. Let's add our media. And we do that by clicking on add media, and it goes into where you can actually search for your media there on your different drives. So I found mine here. And what we're going to do is we're going to take a Three's Company's episode that was done at 720 resolution here for the computer. So it's already converted once. And what we're going to do is we're going to upscale that and click on open. And we can look in at the preview here. And let's see here. Let's just play with it. This is the original, and then this is the upscale. So you can see how it's crisper and sharper along the edges. And you can see it here. What we can do is we're going to click on run and see if it really does do it. So we're going to click on run here, and it's going to upscale the entire episode. Now, we're not going to watch the entire episode. We're just going to watch a few seconds and compare a few frames here. So you can see here, it's going to take about 2 hours to convert 25 minutes of video. Now, this really varies depending on how fast your hardware is or how advanced your hardware is. So if you have newer hardware, this time is done much quicker. Okay, now it's completed the upscale here, and it saved it in a folder, and this folder is under VideoProc Converter AI, and it gives it the name, basically the same name as the original, but it adds something. It adds the 1440 by 992 for it to let you know that's a higher screen resolution. Now what we're going to do is we're going to compare these and actually play a few seconds here. All right, now here is the original on the left, and the upscaled version is over on the right. So if I have a few seconds here of the original. All right, now I'll play the upscaled version. Come and knock on our door. All right. So let's go back to the original. There we go. So you can see So here's the original and here's the upscaled version. And as you can tell, the upscaled version will appear clearer on your large screen TV. Oh, I would like to interject here to please click on that thumbs up icon, as that really helps the channel. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. Well, let's get back to the steps. So we just saw the program upscale a 720 video to 1440. Now let's see it do an image. So we're going to click on add media again. And here is a photo. So we're going to click on that photo of a living room here. And this is the upscaled version right here. So it goes from 2096 by 1080 all the way up to 4192 to 2160. Now your scaling can be increased. So if you wanted it to go up even higher than that, there's even a higher upscaling. Let's go ahead and click on run and compare the results. So now you can see the original and the result of upscaling the image. It is a much larger image. Now let's look at some of the other features within this program. We'll click on the X and we go back to the main menu here. So that was super resolution. It was also frame interpolation. Now, as I mentioned earlier, that is to convert a file to slow motion. So if you can actually change your frames per second and increase your frames per second. A lot of people do this to add the slow motion effect, which is kind of neat. If you have a shaky video, you have the stabilization feature right here. Next is the video converter. Now this is a really handy option here, or feature to have, because now you can convert one file format to another. So if I go over and use video, you'll notice that there's different types here. So we have MP4, MKV, 4K, MP4 AVI, WebM, WMV, Movie, M4V, MP4 for MPEG, and we also have MPEG-2, DVX, 3GP, and all of these here you can convert from one file to another, which is kind of neat. So if you have a movie that will not play on your device, you use this to convert that from the original to the one that will play on your device. So if you say, well, I don't know which one will play on my device, you can also click on device and it says, well, if you have an iPhone, it will take this. If you have an Android, it'll take this type of format. If you have an iPad, it'll take this. So it'll show you which types of devices will read what kind of file formats. And it doesn't stop at movies, because you also have music and also audio. So you have MP3 as well as a host of others, such as WAVE and all the others for sound file formats. And the next feature that we have is the DVD burner. So you can create an ISO or a DVD movie, like a DVD disc there, and it'll take a movie that you have on your computer and convert it over to a DVD type, which is awesome to be played on a DVD player. Next, you have downloader. So if you see a video up on the internet, you can actually use the URL and paste the URL in, and you'll download that video into your machine there. So then you can then play and watch that movie without being on the internet. And the last feature we have is recorder. This allows you to record your screen, webcam, or your screen and your webcam is what I'm using right now, which is pretty cool. So in all, I'm very happy with the features and the ability of the VideoProc Converter AI to actually work with all my videos as well as my music files. So there you have it. You now know how to use the program to convert videos from one file format to another, to upscale them, or even to do other things with your videos. This program link is in the description, by the way, and You can use a lot of those features for free. If you needed to, you can use the pro version to unlock more things in the program. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up. Comment down below if you have a question about this or other things to do with technology. And I really appreciate everyone for watching to the end. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. And y'all have a very good day. Bye-bye.